afternoon are coordinated tactical techniques developed by Navy and Marine Corps pilots in both peacetime training and actual combat. These maneuvers are neither stunts nor daring feats, but refinements of basic techniques taught to every prospective naval aviator. Here in Dayton, we will demonstrate these maneuvers at very low altitude in traditional Blue Angel formation so that you may see and take pride in the precise fashion in which your Navy and Marine Corps pilots are trained to fly. Now, direct your attention to the ramp before you. Observe the military manner in which the six demonstration pilots approach their aircraft and are saluted by their crew chiefs. Ladies and gentlemen, flying Blue Angel number one, the commanding officer and flight leader of the Blue Angels from League City, Texas, Commander Eric Doyle. Flying Blue Angel number two, the right wingman from Fremont, California, Lieutenant Commander Damon Cruz. Flying Blue Angel number three, the left wingman from Memphis, Tennessee, Major Jeff Mullins. Flying Blue Angel number four, the slot pilot from Danville, California, Lieutenant Commander Nate Scott. Flying Blue Angel number five, the lead solo from Kennesaw, Georgia, Lieutenant Tyler Davies. Flying Blue Angel number six, the opposing solo from Wabigo, Kansas, Lieutenant Commander Brandon Hempler. As the crew chiefs assist the pilots into their jets, you are witnessing the teamwork found in every Navy and Marine Corps unit. The Blue Angels take a great deal of pride in personifying the Navy and Marine Corps values of honor, courage, and commitment. And Lieutenant Commander Hempler are approaching to demonstrate the slow-speed handling characteristics of the Hornet in the clean configuration. They'll pass before you, virtually standing Blue Angels 5 and 6 on their tails. From the right, at less than 120 miles per hour, the section High Alpha Pass.
I'm at an all-time high.